You know that I want to be with you all the time. You know that I won't stop until I make you mine. You know that I won't stop until I make you mine. Until I make you mine. Put your hand in mine. You know that I want to be with you all the time. Oh darling, darling, baby, you're so very fine.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. If you're new here, I'm Alex. And that's Lilyana. And then there's Jody, my fiance. And I'm currently 39 weeks and 6 days pregnant. I will be 40 weeks tomorrow, so it's my due date, May 14th. And I'm just doing a last pregnancy update for you guys because this is it. I had a doctor's appointment this morning at 9 a.m. and it was just trying to, like, it was for us to see, like, you know, what we're doing, basically, because they didn't even think that I was going to make it to that appointment. My last appointment, when I was 39 weeks, I had, had my membrane sweeped. And so we thought that for sure last weekend, Mother's Day weekend, she would come, but she hasn't come yet. So I thought I would do this because I'm actually feeling really tired today. So before I got super unmotivated, just wanted to go ahead and answer a couple of questions that you guys might have and then give you guys like a little bump update. And also, if you stay till the end, I have some news on when she will be here and the whole plan with that is. I wrote down the questions that I got, so I'll just go ahead and start answering them. When is your due date? I said at the beginning of the video, tomorrow, Thursday, May 14th is my due date. I will be 40 weeks pregnant. So yeah, I made it. How have you felt being pregnant for a second time? I don't know. Good. A lot more positivity this pregnancy because we're in our home and settled and things like that. It was a little chaotic last time. We had to wait for our house to be ready and things like that. So this time I've just been focusing a lot more on doing pregnancy meditation and my focusing on myself and a lot more self-care. I feel good because I got everything done at a good point. So quarantine didn't really affect me getting many things for like that I needed as far as her bassinet, stroller, new car seat, stuff like that. So I've actually just been chilling and relaxing and kind of enjoying the third trimester because I have finished everything up the second trimester. And I'm also really thankful for our friends and family because they were sending us things like nonstop, and so we were able to get the essentials and things that we needed, and that came in handy. Do you have any food cravings this last trimester? My first trimester, I really didn't have anything crazy. I told you guys that I crave a lot of Oreos. I love them. But even now, like towards the end, I'm not really, they're not tasting as good as they did. So that kind of sucks because I love Oreos. But I mean, I'll always love them. Other than that, I mean, this morning before my doctor's appointment, we had stopped through the drive-thru because we were running late on time. So I had just got a sausage and cheese, what is that, biscuit, and I wanted, grape jelly, and so I asked Tony, and he was like, that's disgusting, and it was bomb, it was pretty bomb. Yeah, so that's probably the weirdest thing that I've craved so far, but I would definitely eat that again. But other than that, I also crave these, the peach Snapples. And then just like a cold glass of water. Like I want like ice water all the time. Just give it to me. Cause I always feel like I'm like tired. I feel like every time I do these videos and I'm sitting down alone, I get like a phone call or my phone just stops. But Tony just FaceTimed me. So I think I was in the food cravings. But yeah, that's been the craziest thing that I've craved. Not really craving any like meats or anything like that, and I've craved desserts like crazy this time, which is not a good thing, but I always want something that's like sweet and salty, so that makes sense why I wanted a sausage biscuit with crepe jelly. Before the pandemic, who did you want in the room with you, and how are you feeling about it being just you and Tony? Well, before the pandemic, I think I was gonna stick to the same people that I had in the room when I had Lilyana. So, my friend, and then Tony and my mom were in the room. And then like last minute, my dad and my siblings showed up, but they were like in the corner in the room. But yeah, other than that, it was just gonna be my mom and Tony and probably Karina. But this time it'll just be me and Tony, and I think it's actually good because this is our last baby. So it just kind of gives us that bonding, you know? He gets to fully just be there for me. Nobody else would be like in the way of that, and it'll be a really beautiful moment, I think. I'm nervous, but I'm ready. Did you suffer from any morning sickness? Horrible morning sickness. I even looked up that one condition. I don't know the name of it, but when you're just constantly throwing up and you can't keep anything down, because literally the first trimester, I thought that it was never gonna end. Like that's how it felt. Cause I wasn't that sick with Lilyana. Like I got sick a couple of times, but yeah, I was sick with this little baby girl. And so it honestly sucked, but got through it and here we are, and now I'm eating everything. But that was like the biggest thing for me, because I was like hungry and starving, and then on top of that it was like I was sick to my stomach, so I wasn't like eating anything. It was sad. I think like that was pregnancy hormones too, because I remember like crying to Tommy and being like, I just want to eat, I'm sick. He's like, you're crying over food. It's like pregnant. How has working out been this pregnancy? Well, if you guys have followed me on social media or you've been in my life for a really long time, you know that fitness is a really big part of my life. So when I was pregnant with Lilyana, I worked out all the time. I worked out through my entire pregnancy. With Tony. This time I worked out pretty far. I want to say 7 months maybe. Around 8 months I started to get really tired, and like I could have pushed through, but I just feel like I've been pushing myself, and I never really take a break from fitness or anything like that. I'm always like working out and stuff. But I just decided to just kind of like, if I felt like working out, I would work out, and it wouldn't be anything crazy. A lot of body weight stuff, it kind of helped me a little bit not feel sad or like left out, because the gyms aren't open. But we have equipment here, but I just try not to think about it that way, because I'll get back into it once my 6 weeks is up from postpartum and I'll be in full swing. But I just feel like you always deserve a break, so it was nice to give myself that break. And yeah, so I worked out until like 7 months, and then I go for walks and stuff like that, but nothing crazy. I'm not like lifting like I was. Just listen to your body, basically. That's like, if like advice wise, it's really good for you to work out and it helps your labor be easier, but at the same time, like, you have to listen to your body, and if you're tired, then you should rest and do things like that. How has Lilyana been knowing baby L is coming? Lilyana's two, so she, I mean, we say baby sister, she repeats baby sister, and things like that. She gives my belly kisses, but I don't think that she full-blown knows that, like, a baby is coming, so it's just as it is day by day. I just remind her, like, baby sister, and then she sends it back to me. She rubs my belly and stuff, so it'll be exciting to see them meet. I'm kind of sad that she won't be able to come to the hospital, you know, and meet her sister like that, but we'll be home and they'll get to spend that time together, and I'm pretty sure they'll be close and stuff like that. I love having a little sister, so, and she'll be closer to her little sister than I am, like, closer in age than I am, so that'll be cool. They'll be growing together. Was it ever hard for you, since you're super into fitness, to see your body changing so much? Personally, I think that it would be hard, not harder, but it would be a difference for anybody. It's like a shock factor, because, like, you literally go from, like, not showing, and then, like, as you look back at, like, your long pictures, which, if you're, like, at the beginning of your pregnancy, I definitely think that you should document, like, throughout, because it's fun to, like, look back on. From, like, month 1 to month 9, but yeah, I definitely feel like sometimes it gets a little bit hard, because, like, you're putting on so much weight rapidly, and you're like, oh, my gains, or, you know, things like that. Thank you. You're kind of just like, you put on a lot of weight really fast, and then, like, some days you just feel really emotional because you're pregnant and your hormones are, like, all over the place, and you're like, I feel fat and stuff like that. But in reality, I love my body. I love seeing my bump grow. I love not just, like, caring about every little detail in my body, honestly, and just letting it know what it's meant to do. And it's growing my daughter, and she's healthy, just like Lilyana, and I'm having a very healthy pregnancy. I'm healthy, so that's all I can honestly ask for, because, you know, that's a blessing in itself. What scares you the most at this point? The one thing that's been, like, lingering in my mind over this whole entire last trimester, and, you know, leading up to my due date, is the COVID-19 test, because I saw a pregnant mom on my Instagram, and she's doing a home birth, so she had to go and get tested at one of the centers, and it looked extremely painful. But then there's, like, mixed emotions, because there's some people who say it's not painful and things like that. Nobody's mentioned anything to me, and so there's that uncertainty that I have, like, in the back of my mind, which sucks. Because I don't like to be uncertain. I like to know exactly what's coming, what's going to happen, and all those things. I meant to ask my doctor today, but there was just so much going on that I had forgot. But yeah, so if I have to get that thing stuck up my nose, that's probably what's scaring me the most right now. And knowing what contractions feel like and how bad they get, that definitely is scary too. Since you'll be having two baby girls, do you think you'll want to try for a boy or another baby at all? It's crossed my mind. I definitely won't say that it hasn't crossed my mind. We're having two girls, so of course, like, I would like for Trinity to have, like, his mini-me, because I feel like I have my mini-me and Lilyana, and then there's going to be another girl. So there's, like, all this estrogen in the house. And, I would love for him to be able to have a little boy. But also me, because, like, mom's boy, duh. But if it happens, it happens. But at this point right now, we kind of had set our goal at two. So I think that this is probably it for us. we're content and happy. We don't really, we weren't bummed or anything that wasn't a boy. We're just a girl mom and a girl dad. What's your favorite part about being pregnant? Honestly, how cute your stuff looks with like your little bump and feeling your baby move. There's like no feeling like that. I look forward to it every day. Just kind of feeling her and like knowing that she's like in there. Ultrasounds and being able to see her growing in there and kind of just trying to be like, oh, I wonder what she's gonna look like and stuff. I fell in love with the last ultrasound that I had, my last one, because her face, like, we got to see her face. I just was emotional and I was just like, yeah, it's my favorite part. I have a couple. Where do you guys want to raise your kids long term? The Chicagoland area. We have a couple of places here in mind that we would like to buy our forever home and be with our kids and actually raise them and be there. But I mean, things happen and me and Tony have talked about living in different states and stuff like that, so it just kind of depends on what we decide, but we definitely want to buy a house with a lot of land that's just ours, and that's where we want to raise our children. What will you miss the most about being pregnant? I mean, this pregnancy, it's just like the constant, like, oh, this is like the last time that I'll have like a bump and stuff like that, so I'll definitely miss that. I don't know, just creating a little you. I think it's a really cool process and I loved it, so that's what I'll miss. What was the hardest part of pregnancy for you? My hips and my back have been killing me. So I feel like my hips have been hurting a lot more. My leg will literally feel like it's like completely like pins and needles type of feeling. So it's kind of been really hard because like there's been nights where I literally can't even stand up on my own. I'll be like, Tony, I have to use the bathroom, and like he'll have to like come over and like walk me to the bathroom. But other than that, the morning sickness was hard. Nothing too critical though. What are the rules in the hospital you'll be delivering at? I've heard some women have to have gone alone. At the beginning, I think I mentioned this in a video, I'm not sure though. At the beginning of this pandemic quarantine thing, I was super duper just like nervous because I kept watching like pregnancy vlogs and other moms, and I was like starting to get stressed out almost. Which I had to take a step back and be like, that's not here. You know, thank God. But I was just kind of scared like that I was gonna have to be completely alone, and that's not something that I wanted. Whether it's just my mom or just Tony, like I just want somebody to be there with me because I don't want to be in all that pain by myself. Yeah, I don't want to be in all that pain by myself. So the rules at the hospital that I'll be delivering at are I can have one support person with me, so that person has to be with me the entire time from the time that I'm checked in to the time that I'm released from the hospital. And if that person leaves it all at home, then that's it, like that person can't come back and I'll just be by myself with the baby. But it'll be Tony, and he doesn't plan on leaving me, so it'll just be us. And I mean, that's fine. And you can't have any visitors or anything like that, which I feel like you really shouldn't have that many people anyways, because like it's a brand new baby and like stuff like that, so no big deal. I've come to kind of like terms with it now. At first it was kind of like, oh my god, my mom will be there, and it was emotional, but she'll be there on my phone and things like that. So also she'll be with Lilyana, which gives me a really good peace of mind to be away from her. Are you going to do a birth video? I plan on it. Now, don't hold me to that because I don't know how, like, you know, Tony might get distracted or I might be in a lot of pain or contractions might be taking over. So it might just be like a little clip by clip, but I plan on from the point that I wake up and have to go to the hospital until the point of pushing. I want to document it all because I know that since my mom and stuff can't be there, like, I want to kind of be able to take, like, you guys and my parents and just, you know, everybody through that process with me because I've watched a lot of birth vlogs and I didn't get to do that with my first pregnancy, and I would like to have, you know, that last pregnancy and stuff like that. And I would also like to have, like, you know, at the end, like, Lilyana meeting baby Al, you know, than just that cute moment. So I want to have all that to look back on our channel, and I want to be able to share that. So I definitely plan on doing a birth vlog. That's all the questions I have, but I just wanted to knock this video out for you guys really quick. It's kind of a quick one. I really don't have much to say. Everything is packed, everything is ready to go. Now, the update that you guys have all been waiting for, if you stayed to this point, then you'll know. If you didn't, then of course, you won't be on the news. But I went to my doctor's appointment this morning, like I said at the beginning, and I'll actually be getting induced tomorrow morning, 8 a.m. I have to call the hospital at 7 to just confirm that they have a bed for me, but yeah, so the process starts tomorrow morning. And I'm nervous, scared, like I'm feeling like all the feels, like once I finally got that call from labor and delivery, I was just like, but I'm excited and she'll finally be here, and she'll be like, if she comes tomorrow, then she'll be here on her actual 40 week mark, like her birth date, what was meant to be her birth date. So that's exciting, unless she comes tonight. Who knows, because just like Lilyana, I was scheduled for an induction a week before, and she decided to come at 2 a.m. on that scheduled induction date. So who knows, but you guys will, because I will be vlogging as much as I possibly can. So from the time that I wake up tomorrow, I'll kind of walk you guys through what I'm doing and until I get into the hospital and things like that. So, I'm nervous, but we got this, and I'm full term, so we'll see how it goes. But also, I'll give you guys the last little bump update. So this is how my bump is looking. Also, let me just try to see if I can get you guys a full view in the. So this is how I'm looking. Lilyana's trying to show you guys her belly, but yeah, that's how I'm looking and stuff like that. I'm gonna try to convince Charity to do the baby mama dance with me tonight because this is the last chance, but who knows. Other than that, thank you guys for following me through. I'm excited to do some postpartum videos and things like that. So if there's anything that you guys want to see from me, Tony, Lilyana, and the new baby, please comment those things below and make sure to like this video so that I know, you know, what support that we're having out there, and I can keep them coming for you guys. I've been really on a journey to grow our channel and things like that this year, so I've really been giving all the videos my all and making sure that I prioritize filming them and stuff like that. So also make sure to follow me on social media, because even if I'm not able to do a birth vlog, I'll definitely be updating things on my story, and Tony will be updating the things that I don't get on his story. So make sure to follow us. I'll have that below in the description box. But thank you guys, and we're gonna have a baby. Bye.